Have you heard the scary headlines such as 55% of Americans have less than $1,000 saved, 70% admit to bad spending habits, and many boomers and Gen X have nothing invested for retirement whatsoever? Welcome back to Empower and Thrive. I'm Christina, a corporate VP with over 20 years' experience. Today, we are talking about how much you should have saved by each age. Thankfully, these headlines don't have to be true for you. But do you know how much you need to have right now? Do you know if you are where you should be? Here's exactly how much you need to save and invest by every age to eventually get out of debt, buy a car, own a house, become a millionaire, and one day retire. On top of that, we'll also cover the average income within various age brackets, my own recommendations to put yourself ahead, and finally what you can do to get yourself back on track if you find yourself falling behind. This way, eventually, you'll never have to worry about being broke in retirement. Your 20s. Your 20s lay the foundation for your financial future, but it doesn't have to be overwhelming. The key is to begin. You'll get to your goal. You just need to start wherever you are and with whatever you have. Let's start by talking about net worth. It's simply everything you own of value, minus any debt. According to the College Investor, the average net worth for a 23-year-old is actually negative $31,571. So, if your net worth is even above zero, you're already ahead of the curve. This figure is heavily influenced by student loan debt, which many young people are dealing with as they begin their careers. But don't worry, the numbers do improve as time goes on. As for income, the median salary for people in their 20s is $37,500 a year. When it comes to retirement savings, the average 401k balance for a 29-year-old is around $10,500, though many likely have less. Here are my recommendations for anyone just starting their career. First, open a Roth IRA and contribute the maximum, currently up to $7,000 a year. It's a sleeper investment that can build substantial wealth for retirement. Next, try to save 20% of your income. Tough, but vital for your future. With a Gen Z savings rate at just 3.4%, starting this habit early makes it easier later. Also, get invested in the markets to gain experience and set up automation for the future. Finally, think about how much you'll need for retirement. If you want to save enough to make you $50,000 a year by the age of 60 just from investments, you're going to need to have at least $1.25 million invested. If you start saving at the age of 20, you can do that entirely within a Roth IRA with as little as $416 a month. Imagine how nice it would feel to have over $1 million saved up and not have to pay any taxes on those gains or withdrawals. Your 30s. According to the College Investor, the average 30-year-old has a net worth of $42,139, and by the age of 35, that amount jumps all the way to $141,000. The median net worth for someone in their 30s is closer to $39,000. In terms of how much people in their 30s are making, the average 30-year-old makes $67,100 a year, while the median salary is $50,000 a year. As far as how much they have invested, according to Investopedia, those between the ages of 30 to 39 have roughly $38,000 within their 401k. The general rule of thumb is, by the age of 30, you should aim to have at least as much as your annual salary saved up and invested. So if you have a salary of $60,000, then that's the amount that you should aim to have saved. This all might seem overly simplistic since this is probably during a time when you're just starting out your career, increasing your income, paying off student loan debt, and maybe buying a house. As your income increases, try to save 20% of your salary. Like I mentioned earlier, a lot of these habits really begin in your 20s, and if you can stick with it, it's going to be really easy to continue into your 30s. For instance, if you're able to save 20% of your income throughout your 20s by the time you're 30, it's really easy to keep saving 20% without even noticing it. But what if you didn't start saving in your 20s and have absolutely nothing saved in your 30s? At this point, you may want to consider taking steps to start catching up. If we are sticking with the goal of earning $50,000 a year from your investments at age 60, and if you're just starting out at the age of 30, it's still absolutely doable. However, it will require that you invest $895 a month instead of $416 a month to catch up. If you're earning the median income of $50,000 a year, this will equate to a 25% savings rate. It's possible, but it's going to take a bit more work. Your 40s. Now, let's talk about people in their 40s because this is where things really begin to take off. That's because they are in what's called their peak earning years, and all the hard work put in over the last 20 years is beginning to pay off. In terms of income, the average 40-year-old earns $78,334 a year. Throughout your 40s, the average person has a net worth of $713,000, while the median net worth is $126,000. The difference is slightly skewed due to billionaires. Most people will have closer to the median of $126,000. The average 401k balance of someone in their 40s is about $93,000. Generally, most articles and experts say that by the age of 40, you should have 3 times your annual income saved and invested. To do this, assuming you need 3 times the average $70,000 salary, you'd need to save approximately 20% of your income starting at age 25, assuming a 7.5% return. This would give you about $220,000. But what if you partied a bit too hard or something, and now you are 40 and have absolutely nothing saved? If you're starting at age 40 with $0 and want to retire at 60 with $1.25 million, you'll need to invest $1,750 a month to catch up. This may seem incredibly daunting, but it is what you will need to save to catch up. This is why every investment advisor everywhere keeps saying, start saving as early as possible, because it really does make everything else so much easier. But remember, it's never too late to begin, and every step forward counts. Here are a few things to focus on to help you get to your goal. Number one, focus on maxing out retirement accounts annually. This includes maxing out your Roth IRA currently at $7,000 a year, a 401k up to $23,000 a year, or an HSA up to $4,150 a year. Second, you should also aim to maximize your earnings over the next 10 years. As you approach some of the highest earning years of your life, it's important to make the most of it. It was found that employees who stay within the same company for more than a few years get paid on average 50% less than someone who changes jobs more frequently, and that should be taken into consideration. Your 50s. Now, let's start talking about how things begin stacking up at age 50. The median net worth for someone at this age is about $259,000, while the average net worth is much higher at $1.3 million, again, boosted by billionaires who skew the numbers. It's interesting to note that income during your 50s doesn't change much compared to your 40s. The median salary remains around $60,000 a year, with higher earners bringing in about $650,000 a year. By this stage, many standard guidelines suggest having 5 times your annual salary saved. For example, if you're earning $70,000 a year, that would mean having $350,000 saved. While this might sound like progress, if your goal is to have $1.25 million saved by age 60 for a comfortable retirement, sticking to this advice may leave you feeling behind. That's why I recommend aiming to save at least 8 times your annual salary. Think about this. If you had started investing just $416 a month at age 20, by the time you reach 50, that could grow to nearly $600,000, putting you much closer to your retirement goals. Your 60s. The median income for this age group is about the same, at $58,000 a year. As for net worth, the median is around $490,000, while the average is significantly higher at $1.6 million. This is usually when your income has peaked or begun to decline. If you're in your highest earning years, it's smart to save the majority of your income. Most standard guides say you should have about 7 times your annual income saved by this point. I slightly disagree. By age 60, ideally, you should have 10 to 12 times your annual income saved. If you start thinking about this by age 30, you can easily achieve this by investing 10% of your salary with a 7% return. If you bump that to a 20% savings rate, you could easily save 20 times your annual income within 30 years. Obviously, my numbers are meant to be a rough ballpark or a guideline. Some people may be ahead or behind, but that's not the point. The point is that right now is the best time to start. The sooner you begin building good financial habits, the easier it will be. Even if you're not where you want to be, it starts small with budgeting, saving extra money, investing consistently, putting it on autopilot, and maximizing your income. If you like this video, check out my video on the optimal order to save and invest, which should help you put a timeline to each investment option you're considering. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. And as always, keep thriving.